गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, टुडे वी विल टेक द स्टोरी ऑफ फुटप्रिंट विदाउट फीट बोली। द राइटर ऑफ दिस स्टोरी इज के ए अब्बास। नाउ बोली, बोली इज द नेम ऑफ ए गर्ल एंड दिस स्टोरी इज अबाउट ए गर्ल। फ्रॉम हर वेरी चाइल्डहुड बोली वॉज नेग्लेक्टेड एट होम। वाई डिड हर टीचर टेक स्पेशल इंटरेस्ट इन हर? डिड बोली मेजर अप टू हर टीचर्स एक्सपेक्टेशन? यू विल रीड इन दिस पोयम। इट इज़ ए वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी ऑफ ए वेरी ब्रेव यंग गर्ल हु स्टैंड्स अप फॉर हर ऑनर एंड सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट। शी रिबेल्स अगेंस्ट द डाउरी सिस्टम विच इज ए blot on the Indian social system. It is her education that gives her the strength to fight against an unjust social order. This lesson underlines the need to educate every girl child. If Bholi had not received education, she would have been no more than a dumb cow. Her real name was Sulekha, but since her childhood everyone had been calling her Bholi. She was given this second name because she was simpleton. She was the poor daughter of the village Nambardar Ramlal. When Bholi was just 10 months old, she had fallen from the court. As a result, some part of her brain was damaged. She grew up as a dull child. At the time of her birth, Bholi was very fair, pretty. Due to ill luck, she had an attack of smallpox when she was only 2 years old. As a result, her body was disfigured by deep black pock marks. She could not speak clearly. When she stammered, other children made fun of her. Ramlal, Bholi's father, was quite worried about her future. Bholi was the youngest of his 7 children. All the children except Bholi were healthy and happy. Radha, the eldest daughter, was already married. Mangla and Champa were good-looking and healthy girls. Ramlal had no worry taking about these daughters, but he was worried taking about Bholi because she was neither beautiful nor intelligent. Bholi was 7 years old when a primary school was opened in the village. The tehsildar came to perform the opening ceremony. He asked Ramlal to send the girls to the school and to set an example for the villagers. She said, if girls go to school, who will marry them? Still, Ramlal did not want to disobey the tehsildar. So, his wife agreed to send Bholi to school. And now, Bholi went to school. Bholi was dressed in clean clothes that day. She was given a bath, oil. This was something new to her. Earlier, she had to wear the old dresses of her sister. That was a new experience for her to go to school. The headmistress asked Bholi to sit down in one of the classrooms. Bholi did not know the meaning or purpose of the school, but she was happy watching. There are so many other girls of her age. The lady teacher in the class was saying something to the other girls. At first, Bholi was unable to understand what was she saying. She just looked at the pictures on the wall. The teacher asked Bholi her name, but she could not speak. She was stammering. The teacher encouraged her to speak out her name. After a few attempts, she was able to speak her name. The teacher petted her. Now, the teacher gave a book to Bholi. It had nice pictures of dog, cat, of different animals, birds. The teacher told her she would be able to read in a month. Then she would read a bigger book. No one would laugh at her. Bholi was very happy to hear it. After many years, the village became a small town. The primary schools became a high school. Now there was a cinema and a cotton dining mill. The mail train began to stop at their railway station. One night after dinner, Ramlal asked his wife if they should accept Visambar's proposal to marry Bholi. because he was very rich. December was 45 or 50. He walked with a limp. He had children from his first wife, but he had a big shop and a house of his own. Guli also heard their talks. On the fixed day, December Nath came as a bridegroom, and they got. Guli's sister seemed to be jealous of her. Ramlal was very happy to see all the pomp and show. He never dreamed that his youngest daughter would enjoy such a fine wedding. At the fixed time, the priest asked for the bride's entry. Guli was dressed in a red silken bridal sari. One of Bisambar's friends asked Guli to garland the bridegroom. Bisambar had a quick look at her face. He asked his friend if he had seen the pock marks of Guli's face. His friend replied that it did not matter since he was also not young. Bisambar asked her a dowry of 5,000 rupees. Ramlal was upset and he requested very much. He offered 2,000 rupees, but Bisambar did not relax his demand, so Ramlal had to give 5,000 rupees. Guli was looking at Bisambar with contempt. When Bisambar raised the garland to place it round Guli's neck, she broke the garland and threw it into the fire. She told her father that she would never marry to a greedy person. She had prepared herself to go for an unequal marriage, but she would not like to marry a very greedy person. Now, some people say that Guli had proved to be a shameless girl. She wondered how a dumb cow like Guli could behave like that. Guli replied that this dumb cow had learned to speak. December and his party decided to return, and ceremony of marriage was cancelled. Guli's father was filled with shame and grief. When everybody was gone, Guli's father asked her about her future. Guli said in a very calm voice that she would serve her mother and father in their old age. She would teach in the same school where she learned so much. Sulekha's teacher, who was watching this drama, approved of her decision. She looked at Sulekha in the same way as an artist looked at his masterpiece. And now I think you are able to understand the story fully. Thank you.